About to go look at some flip cars here at a local little dealership. Just some cheaper cars I could flip, because I'm trying to get this. I'm buying this Trans Am. I don't know if you guys. I don't know. I don't think I'm posting this video, but I'm buying a car that is pretty cool. Probably pretty familiar. And I dropped some cash for it, and I want to make that cash back up. Got to keep flipping. So we're going to check out some cars and maybe take the truck through some mud holes and see what we can do. But first, I want to get underneath it really quickly and just hit some stuff with hammered finish undercoating and just some stuff where it's rusting to prevent rust, some rust reformer and stuff. So I got this, which actually has some really pretty good reviews for using it in trucks. And I got some truck bed coating, which is kind of cool, so I'm going to try out that underneath it. So first off, you can kind of see this truck is kind of rusty. I'm going to hit this area so it quits rusting, because this stuff, it's hard for rust to go through hammered stuff and like undercoating. So and I'm going to hit the frame a little bit, I think. But I've already done the frame a few times, so it's doing pretty good. But mainly just a couple other areas. So let's see how it looks. Let's try the bed coating. I think that'd be kind of cool.
Growing up, parents got me a guitar. Said you could do anything, kid, you could go far. You could be the president, fireman, race cars. The sky's the limit, kid, so shoot for the stars.
Going out and you can see that rainbow. There's a double rainbow. I don't know if you can see the second ring. It's pretty cool. You can even see the purple. Got some pictures with my truck in front of me. It looks super sick just out here. Don't mind that heat shield you can hear kind of vibrating. But it's a 2009 F-150 Platinum. It was my dad's. He gave it to me until he trades it in, but it's mine for now. So I have it for another few months. I've had it for a couple months, and I love it. So it's my work truck, and once he takes it and trades it in, whatever he's getting, I'm going to go out and get another. I think I'm going to get a Platinum, too. It's just so good to have a truck and to have a work truck. Now, a lot of people don't get Platinums for work trucks, but I'm going to either get, if I get a Ford, which I'm probably going to, I'll probably get another Platinum. I'll either get a Platinum or a King Ranch, but probably a Platinum. And I would probably get like this, like a 2000, I think it's 12, no, 2011, 12, 13, or 14, because those have the 5.0, I believe. Well, I know the 13, 14 do, but I'm pretty sure the 11 and 12 do also. This one has the 5.4 Triton V8, but I'd get the 5.0 and, get some nice wheels on it. These are really nice, but they're stock. They're usually chrome, but I painted them black, and they're on these Toyo Open Country Extremes here, 20s, which is pretty good for stock. I'm not sure if it's lifted or leveled or anything. We think it's either leveled or lifted about 1 inch, because it definitely doesn't feel like stock ride height. The Ford dealership thinks it's lifted. That when my dad had some work done, they told him that, just so he knew. But yeah, it's super nice. Super Crew extended cab. Super Crew, it'll be the Super Crew. And I don't know if this is, I don't think this is the long box. I think it's, it might be. I actually do think it is the long box. I don't really know the exact specs on this truck, but I know it's the Super Crew. It's got, one thing that helps for work is it's got so much space back here. It's got the automatic running boards. It's got the brown leather. Such a nice truck. And I love using it for like landscaping and stuff, and hauling car parts and towing cars is what I've used it for so far. It's just such a nice truck. super smooth ride, even with the aggressive, more mud aggressive tires, I guess, Toyota Open Countries. But if I was gonna have this for a little bit longer, which I might still do, I'm thinking about ordering wheel spacers for it, like some nice ones, some actually high-end ones that aren't gonna be cheap and are actually gonna ride good. Probably some 1.5 or 2 inch wheel spacers so I get some poke. They're right about flush now with the fenders, with these beefy tires that were put on. But I'm thinking about the wheel spacers just to give it some poke and give it a little bit better look, I guess. Yeah, it's just such a nice truck, and this is my work truck. Just wanted to do a video on it here. It's got all this stuff. And if I get the one with the 5.0, it's gonna end up having a big screen, which will be nice. It's got the Sony sound. It's really, really good. It gets terrible gas mileage, but I do use the 85 because it is capable. A lot of room. It's got the sunroof. Just such a nice truck here, high above the ground, a lot of features, and this is just a 2009, so it's the 5.4, like I said. Yeah. Four-wheel drive. Yeah. There's so much room back there because it's the Super Crew. It's super dirty right now because I've been using it for work. Oh, I could jump it. Getting some looks of it. See how this thing is, it's fun. It's just accelerated in four-wheel high. I don't know if you can see my tracks, but it's the four-wheel drive works great. This thing will go through anything. The snow is not a problem. It's getting to be a little bit of a problem because the tires are getting more worn down. But when it's got these good tires on it, when they're in good shape, snow is no problem for this truck. Mud's no problem. It's only the F-150. It's not even the 250 with the diesel or anything. I'm just gonna stick with an F-150 when I get my truck. I wanted to get a brand new Silverado Midnight Edition, but they quit making them in 2018 because that's the last year of that body style. But if I find a good deal on one used, I'll go with that truck because that is like my dream truck. But these are a lot more affordable, these F-150s, because they're a lot cheaper. They're in the high teens, low 20s, in good shape with pretty low miles, you know, around 100K or something, a little bit lower. This one has 150 something. But you wouldn't know it by looking at it. But yeah, so that's kind of my options. It's either one of these or the Midnight Edition. But I kind of want one of these. I just love them when they're done right. I want a black one. I'd either get black or pearl white. But if it's the Midnight Edition, obviously I get black because that's what they are. All right, so we're back home now. Talked about the work truck a little bit. And I love it. It's nice to have all the features of the Platinum. Even though that one doesn't have a big screen, it still has like a backup camera. It's got the really nice Sony sound. I'll show you guys something here. More features that I really like on the inside of it. It's got the cooled seats, which is awesome. Heated seats, there's, you know, a lot of trucks have them, but cooled seats, it's nice. It's got the Microsoft right there, the aux plug-in USB cable, super deep center console, lots of room, garage door openers. It's just super nice. So now I undercoated that before we went mudding. And I want to show you guys one more thing. Another cool thing. At least that I did is I dipped the Ford emblem. It looks super good. Plasti dip. And yeah. So now we're going to undercoat the Maxima and touch up the wheels. Because I can't believe this wheel is. It's like. I just scratch it. But it's like rusting, basically, which is really weird. I mean, it's like, it's weird. But, so we're going to touch up, so I'll get in here and stuff on all of them, and I'm going to jack it up, and then I'll put something in there to cover up the calipers and the rotors, because they're brand new, so I don't want to get any overspray on those. Oh my god. if you guys remember, holy crap, my car did get hit more. So the previous video, I talked about how I got hit up there, how I noticed it. Well, now look. I didn't look. I thought I looked back here, but it was dark in the garage. And look at this. So this is a scratch. This whole thing is actually scratched. And right there. Someone hit the car, for sure. So it's bubbling a little bit of rust right here, which is not good. See what I can do about that. And then down in here, it's starting to rust a little bit. So I'm gonna see what I can do about that. The only rust I've ever seen on this car was right here where I had sanded it and fixed it. It's coming back a little bit, but not too bad. And but this side is actually getting it a little bit more, which is weird.
You're so hot, so you could murder me, and I wouldn't feel a thing. Bittersweet in your protection, darling, saving me from yourself. You're so hot, so you could murder me, and I wouldn't feel a thing. Bittersweet in your protection, darling, saving me from yourself. I love your love, it's murder. Your love, my love, it's killing me. So I love your love, it's murder. Your love, my love, it's killing me. So I love your love, I love your love.
Touched up under here, painted stuff black that's meant to be black, and then whatever silver is, whatever's meant to be like silverish is silver, so everything is looking better now. Got all the way under the car, front and back, side to side, undercoated on a lot more than just the frame. I used about a can and a half of that hammered finish undercoating. There was very little rust under there, a couple spots on this side that I got on the exhaust, but I literally coated everything with 2 to 3 layers of thick coating, so we should be good to go for now. That's about all I'm gonna do on this thing for now. I'm not gonna touch the wheels up because it's filthy, full of ash and stuff, and it's just, I don't know if you can see. Yeah, it's full of ash and crap, and I'd have to really clean them good first. So I'm gonna wait till I power wash it first, then clean it. So yeah, that's just gonna be a video on kind of undercoating this, protecting, and then a little video on the work truck. Next few videos should be a little bit more exciting. Getting this thing fixed, the new car showing up, stuff like that. More parts coming in for this. Maybe a few off-roading videos in the white truck. That'd be pretty fun. If you're new to the channel, there's Bella and Lara. Bella's all happy. Lara looks scared because, well, we rescued her from a different country from being stoned to death. So she's been very abused, so she's making really good progress. So she really loves us, and especially loves my girlfriend. Will not leave her side. Point is, you guys see that soccer ball down there? We're going to the park, gonna play some soccer with the dogs. Thought I'd get it on GoPro and I'll catch up with you guys when we get there. My windshield is absolutely caked in bugs. I don't know if you guys can pick that up on GoPro, but it's absolutely filthy. This whole truck needs a bath, but I've been saving it. I've been having fun with it, working. It's been the best work truck this past week. It's always been like a work truck for me, but this past one, probably 2.5 weeks, it's been a legit work truck. You know, mud, filth, dirt. Oh, you guys see that Corvette that went by? But you know, it's been a dog hauler, and the main thing is work, and it's filthy. I got to clean out the bed. I got to just completely deep clean inside and out of this truck. Especially with the baby coming, it's got to be clean. Looks like there's a few dogs here. Oh, there's another German Shepherd. You don't see that very much. But they're all on the little dog side, so we're gonna go to the big dog side.
Could go back to that day we met, I probably would just stay in bed. You run your mouth all over town, and this one goes out to the sound of breaking glass on my Range Rover. Pay me back, good bitch, it's over. All the presents I would send, fuck my friends behind my shoulder. Next time I'ma stay asleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep. And you got me thinking lately, bitch, you crazy. And nothing's ever good enough. I wrote a little song for you. It go like, oh, break me for so fucking done with you, girl. So fucking done with all the games you play. I ain't no tic-tac-toe. Save the X and O's on another note. I'm done. Break me for so, break me for so, break me for so.
Oh,